Hey everyone, I'm Jackie Jing with Anime News Network, and Rumiko Takahashi is a living legend. She is one of the most popular and successful mangaka of all time. She has created some unforgettable characters and storylines, combining romance and fantasy and adventure, putting all three of them together sometimes. She's pretty much remarkable. But there are very few manga creators who've had the influence that she has on millions of people across the globe. So we thought that it was time to pay her homage and break down the five best anime adaptations from Rumiko Takahashi. All right, let's do it. A genuine cultural phenomenon in the early 2000s, Takahashi's Inuyasha stars the spunky, self-assured Kagome, the reincarnation of a legendary priestess. Kagome, get this, falls into a well and is somehow transported to this fantasy version of Sengoku Japan. Folks, this is isekai. Just saying. There she meets a rowdy, intemperate half-dog, half-demon named Inuyasha, who helps her over the course of 167 episodes and a sequel series, bringing the show's total to nearly 200 episodes in its entirety, recollect the shards of an ancient and powerful jewel, along with a memorable cast of lovable friends. Inuyasha and his dreamy half-brother, Sesshomaru, launched 1,000 ships among fans back in the day. Sesshomaru. Anime crush list for sure. Anyway, it's no wonder that this show caught on and basically ran forever. Takahashi's most famous work centers usually around romantic comedies, but ain't gonna lie, she has some pretty impressive horror stories as well. One of her best and most beloved among fans of anime from the early 90s is the OVA Mermaid Scar, which is an adaptation of a story from Mermaid Saga, a three-part series where Takahashi brilliantly twists what you normally expect from a story about mermaids. With animation by Studio Madhouse, this is one that you definitely want to add to the spooky list. Actually, just put the rest of Takahashi's remarkable catalog of horror stories on there as well. One of the most famous anime comedies ever created, Ranma One-Half. It follows the adventures and misadventures of Ranma Seotomi, who falls into a cursed spring that means that whatever social construct, changes into a woman every time he comes in contact with cold water, along with a crazy cast of sitcom characters that kept the gags running for years. This manga sold over 49 million volumes in Japan, and the show made an impact on Western fandom that can still be felt today, originally released in the early days of US anime fandom on VHS. Hugely influential and still beloved by millions, Ranma One-Half will always hold a special place in many anime fans' hearts. This is not your typical alien invasion, okay? An alien named Lum, wearing a globally recognized leopard print bikini, along with her enormous father and a whole force of beings called the Oni, invades Earth. Instead of just conquering us weak humans, though, they decide to give us a shot at salvation. So they challenge us to a game of tag, and the person who winds up with the responsibility of saving us all happens to be the horniest boy who ever lived. Ataru. Anime fandom was never the same afterward. Spanning 195 episodes and a ton of OVAs and theatrical films, Lum's iconic design and hilarious stories featuring a huge cast of lovable weirdos dominated the 80s in Japan and still stands out today as some of the most beloved characters of all time. Someone please release this show again. It hasn't been available for years and we love it. It is awesome. We'd like to have it back. So please. Drumroll, please! Oh crap, I can't do that. It messes up the mic. Anyway, yeah, that's a fine introduction for Takahashi's finest work, at least in our opinion, and it is a romantic comedy that features Godai, who's down on his luck and winds up living in a boarding house among another cast of wacky sitcom characters. You may be sensing a pattern here. Well, there's also a beautiful but very emotionally damaged widow named Kyoko in this story. It takes a while, and there are plenty of comedy hijinks in between all the romance, but slowly, these two come together, and Godai learns the value of what it means to become the loving, accepting partner of someone who needs a lot of emotional space without forcing it, without disrespecting Kyoko's needs. There are romantic rivals and an adorable dog, and it all comes together beautifully in the end. It's a wonderful, touching story of what real partnership should probably look like, and how difficult it can be to get there. Where's my Godai at? Someday, maybe. Someday. And Viz Media is re-releasing the manga soon, so you'll have a chance to read the story for yourself. Okay, just reading that one gave me the feels. I need to go. I'm like starting to get a little watery-eyed. So yeah, just remember to follow Anime News Network and all of us on the social media platforms. That one's a good one.